Greetings, Jedis. Today we are inside of the Millennium Falcon, and we are going to be taking a look at some of the things inside of the Millennium Falcon to look at and make graphs and data. We may do some adding and some subtracting. Everyone say hello to my friend BB-8. There he goes. He is going to take us on a tour of all the things inside, and we will be collecting data. Are you ready? Let's go. Today we are looking at different types of data, such as a graph, and we are going to be answering some questions about that graph. So the first graph we have is a picture graph. And if you'll look at the top of the graph, there is a lightsaber count. So these pictures are of lightsabers from Star Wars, and they are all different colors. Look to the left side of the graph. You will see labels of each picture: blue, red, green, and purple lightsabers. Look at the top right of the graph. You will see a key. Now, a key tells you what each picture means. So, for example, if you see one lightsaber picture, that equals counting one lightsaber. Sometimes a key could mean that one lightsaber picture would equal counting two lightsabers. The key is up to you, but I chose that one lightsaber picture would equal counting one lightsaber. So our first question about this graph is, which color of lightsabers have the same amount? So if we look across at the blue, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blue lightsabers. We have 1, 2, 3 red lightsabers. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 green lightsabers. And we have 1, 2, 3 purple lightsabers. Now, they want to know which color has the same amount. Look at your pictures. Which ones are the same? And also look at how you answer this question. The question is, which color? So that means your answer will be a color and not a number, because I know sometimes we rush through questions and we might know that the red and the purple both have 3 lightsabers. So you would want to say 3, but that would not be correct, because the question is, which color? So red and purple have the same amount. On the next slide, we are using the same graph and the same data. And if you look, the title, the labels, and the key are all still the same. The question has changed. The question is, how many blue and green lightsabers are there combined? Look at that, and look at the specific labels they are asking for. Blue and green. And they want to know how many are there combined. When we combine something, are we adding or subtracting? You're right. We're adding. So look at how many blue there are. There are 6 blue lightsabers. And look at how many green. There are 5 green lightsabers. So our equation would be 6 plus 5. 6 plus 5 equals 11. So there are 11 blue and green lightsabers combined. Our next question for this graph is, how many more green lightsabers are there than purple lightsabers. So, again, we need to find the specific labels, and we're talking about green and purple. So, the question says, how many more? Now, that tells us when we're asking how many more, we are comparing. And when we compare something in math, are we adding or subtracting? We are subtracting. So, how many green lightsabers are there? There are 5. How many purple lightsabers are there? 3. So, we have 5 minus 3. To figure out how many more green lightsabers there are than purple. 5 minus 3 equals 2. So there are 2 more green lightsabers than purple lightsabers. Today's challenge is to create a picture graph about something you are interested in. Be sure to make a title for your graph. Make sure to label each object on your graph. Create a graph key. And then create one or two questions for your audience to answer about your graph and include the answers to your questions. Have fun!